hard to believe it's been 50 years since NASA embarked on an amazing journey in which three humans left the planet Earth for the first time to visit another celestial body. Through coincidence and orbital mechanics, this journey would fall over Christmas time, the epic journey of Apollo 8. Twas T-minus 10 with the world looking on. Three brave souls prepared an epic journey at dawn. The rocket was stacked on the pad so precise, with oxygen billowing neath tanks wreathed in ice. Launch controllers were nestled at consoles so near, watching temperatures, voltages, making sure all was clear. Atop the Saturn, 300 feet high off the ground, the astronauts faced skyward, where they'd shortly be bound. Destined to fly to parts far and unknown, the first humans in history to truly leave home. Around our neighbor, they'd circle before turning back, returning home to the blue marble suspended in black. As the seconds ticked down, the rocket rumbled to life, millions of parts humming in a sequence so precise. The world held its breath in awe of the sight, as engines awakened and shot forth their first light. An eruption of flame chased by incredible sound, the people of Florida feeling quakes in the ground. The rocket leapt skyward as the world rejoiced, with the mission now heralded by a thundering voice. Now Borman, now Lovell, now Anders, take flight for Kennedy, for Grissom, for Chaffee, and White. To the farthest of reaches, to the heavens beyond, now fly away, soar away, slip free the Earth's surly bonds. Mere minutes passed by, three stages dropping away. Two more hours till it's time for Houston to say, Apollo 8, you are go for TLI. The engines roused from their slumber, toward the moon they did fly. With stars guiding their way like explorers of old, the brave travelers spiraled on in a barbecue roll. Then 3 days later, they passed out of sight to the far side of the moon and an orbit just right. Around and around the gray landscape they flew, seeing sights for humans all new. Reporting on craters, some round, some bland, so that those soon to follow would know where to land. Four circuits complete, when to their Christmas surprise, peeking over the horizon, a magnificent Earthrise. There's the Earth coming up, cried Anders enraptured. Then the snap of a shutter, and for all time, history was captured. After nine rings around the grayish bleak ball, a camera brought the world aboard for a Christmas Eve call. While lunar vistas streamed across millions of screens, the people of this good Earth sat enthralled by that scene. They set sail for the good Earth on their chariot of fire. Houston reporting, there is a Santa Claus, a phrase to admire. It was then 2 days' flight toward a globe growing in size, before a fiery plummet that would light up the skies. Their windows grew hazy as the bright plasma flared, while safe in their chairs, the brave explorers prepared the jolt of the parachutes, and then a long float on down to splash in the ocean, now home, safe and sound. With an end to their journey, they were hailed heroes true, the first men in history to get so close to the moon. Soon thereafter, others would follow in line to continue the greatest adventure across all space and across all time. Happy holidays to all from NASA and from all of us here at the Johnson Space Center.